In today's video, I asked my locals to put together a mystery pack for me with $50. So we're going to crack it open and see what booster packs are in here and if we can get some good hits. Let's jump into the video. Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for being here. Please be sure to hit that like button if you do enjoy the content, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Click the bell icon if you want to be notified when new videos are posted. But I've done some mystery openings on the channel before from like the Target mystery boxes, Walmart, etc. that have been really fun. And I had an idea because I've seen some people do similar content. I have a local shop that I go to, and they're sort of a distributor slash locals, if you will, so they get pretty good prices on stuff. But they also carry a ton of product. There's a large assortment of stuff. I can find like sealed magic boosters packs from like, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 years ago, and they're all at pretty good prices. So I asked them to build me a mystery pack. I don't know what's in here. I would imagine that there's probably going to be a mix of more recent stuff and other stuff, but it's sealed, and it's just, I mean, it's not a fancy packaging because it's sort of like a custom because I had the idea for a video, but we're going to go ahead and jump into it and actually see what we can get. And I can't actually, these things are a nightmare to peel. But I asked them to do that for me. So we're going to go one at a time here on this and see what we've got for packs. I spent $45 for this. So we're going to see if the value will pay for itself. I'm guessing some of these are probably still going to have price stickers on them because they usually sell everything from shelves. So, all right, well, that's a pretty damn good start. A Commander Masters Draft Booster. Big fan of this set as a whole, and these are pretty good. I think they sell these around 11, but I think online they're a couple bucks more. I know the majority of retail, LCS's place, that was like 15 to 17, but I think they're clearing out some of their stock as well. Modern Horizons 3, I have to be honest, I kind of expected this because they did say that like they had some of the bit of this. I figured he'd probably throw some of the new stuff in there, which is cool because I haven't actually opened any Modern Horizons 3 on the channel yet, so that's pretty neat. What is this? Kaldheim set booster. This is a couple years old now. Vorinclex, though, the good Vorinclex is in there, as well as the Pathway Land, so there's definitely stuff to potentially hit. Let's see what else. Another Modern Horizons. I think I had said no dupes if possible, but that's okay. I mean, this is a great set, and I've opened a bazillion of them off camera, so. And we've got, what is this? Streets of New Capenna set booster. Decent, not the best, but I mean, there's some pretty good heavy hitters in here. And the last one is Theros Beyond Death. So that's before we had set play boosters, what have you. So six packs, $45 worth. I'm relatively satisfied with this. Not a bad assortment. So we're going to go ahead and get these opened up, and I'll probably save the bigger packs towards the end. What are we even striving for in Theros? I'm honestly not sure. I have not opened much of this set at all. And I'm not sure what we're actually looking for in the set. I know there's probably some decent hits. I'm looking it up as we speak, so I have a reference here. Theros Beyond Death. There's a cool lands. And it looks like in terms of value, the best hits out of here, Nyxbloom Ancient, which would be great, honestly. Thassa's Oracle, Shadow Spear. There's some pretty good stuff in here. So, man, I've been wanting to get another Nyxbloom Ancient for a while. That would be one I'd be really, really pumped to hit. So let's see how we do. I do like the assortment of packs. I'm hopeful that means there's at least a chance we get something good. So I'm pretty sure the rare is going to be at the front. So we'll move it like this. I don't know too much about these. Sage of Mysteries, Unknown Shores, Wrap in Flames, Altar of the Pantheon. I think this is a decent card. Dreadful Apathy, Deny the Divine, Revoke Existence, Thirst for Meaning, Gift of Strength, Soul Reaper of Mogus, Mogus's Favor. And then, so I think the rare will likely be here. These do look really nice, I will say. I like these a lot. And it's Protean Thaumaturge. And, well, I guess that's a weird, okay, I guess the rare is just kind of in the middle there, which I guess is good to know. This did not pop up. Whenever enchantment enters battlefield, you may have it become a copy of that enchantment till end of turn, except it has this ability. It did not show up on any of the first couple pages, so I'm going to guess it's not anything crazy, but it's still neat. I don't, like I said, I very, very rarely open any of this set. Yeah, it's got to be less than a dollar because it's not even on the first, like, four pages. But that's sort of the thing with the draft boosters. All right, so we'll go to New Capenna next. The thing I know about these New Capenna set boosters is they do have a good chance for list hits, which is nice. So let's see what we've got here for the art card. This is that's Luxor's Gift. We've got a Foil Plains. This set is kind of notoriously not good, but there are the Triomes and a few decent hits. Extract the Truth, Glamorous Outlaw, Shattered Seraph, Crooked Custodian, Mr. Orfeo the Boulder, Quasa or Augur of Agonies, wow, Scuttling Butler, Waterfront District, Rico Cabaretti Caterer. I really liked when they did the gilded foils for these. And then Wiretapping, and speaking of which, I actually hit one. All right. I don't think it's worth much, but this is one of the gilded foils. It's, you can feel the bump kind of on the side there. I'm not going to complain about that. These are really, really nice. It's a shame they used such a cool-looking foil for a set that was really lackluster. I do not think this is worth anything crazy, but I'll put the values up on the screen for, like, the rare hits, just so you guys can follow along if it's something that interests you. And if you guys want to see more mystery content like this, definitely let me know. It's something different that I'm trying, but I think they're usually fun to open, so... Let's see. Call time is, let's see. I don't know what we got here. Nice. This set has some good hits. Snow-covered forest. I think the snow-covered lands are solid. Raise the Draugr. Infernal Pet. Village Rites. Not a terrible card. Priest of the Haunted Edge. Dread Rider. Dogged Pursuit. Draugr Recruiter. Frost Augur. And, oh, let's go, guys. Holy crap. I actually did hit one. Vorinclex Monstrous Raider. That's an insane pull. I'm going to put a sleeve on that guy. And Priest of the Haunted Edge. What a hit. Dude, this card is nuts. I grabbed one pack of Kaldheim hoping to hit this. This is actually an insanely good card. And it's the sick showcase style. I'm pretty sure this is genuinely like a $40 to $50 card. So I think that, you know, we made our value back there for sure. Nice hit with the Vorinclex. All right, Modern Horizons 3. Now, if I remember correctly, because I've opened a bunch of these, there's two different pack layouts, and I'm fairly certain that on these ones, the rare are actually in the front. So we'll slide it back a couple, and we'll just see what happens. Static Prison, Lion Umbra, Cyclops Superconductor, Nyxborn Unicorn, Eldrazi Repurposer, Shattered Landscape, Sargian... I botched that so bad, now I need to fix it. Sarpedion Simulacrum, Tune the Narrative, Breathe Your Last. So we're on our art card, which is... Oh, I forget this. This is the Battlemore Captain. Cool card, though. Nightshade Dryad. Eldrazi Linebreaker. Nesting Ground. Boggart Trawler. And that. So, Eldrazi Linebreaker. Pretty cool card. Not bad. Not competitively on the level of a lot of the other Eldrazis. But in the spawn version of the deck, it is quite good. I will say that. Let's go. Let's see if we get some better luck here. Give me a Titan. Or a special guest would be lit. We're going to do the same thing we did here, where we go 1, 2, 3. We're going to put those to the back. And then our art card is Sorin. Nice. Really cool looking art, actually. Golden Tail Trainer. Amp Raptor. This is an insane card. Contaminated Landscape. Dog Umbra. This is such a good set, too. It really is. Foul Strike. Cranial Ramp card got banned in a Pauper. Utter Insignificance. Grave Dig. Infernal Captor. And then so our rare is going to be after this. It is going to... I lied to you. Sorry. Phyrexian Ironworks, our rare is going to be Kudo, King Among Bears. Oh, and we actually got two. We got a Ruby Medallion, which is not bad. This has gone up pretty significantly, even since the re-release, because of the Ruby Storm deck in Modern that's playing four copies. So I'll take it. It's a decent hit. It's at least worth, like, the price of the pack. All right, this is the big one, though, guys. Commander Masters. What a cool set. A little overpriced, I think, generally speaking, in terms of, like, what you get out of the product. But we're going to put these to the back. And we're going to see what we get out of Commander Masters. I opened a lot of these on the channel back in the day. Loyal Apprentice, Soul Ring, can't go wrong. That means I'm probably not going to get the cool all art one. Loyal Guardian, Courage in Crisis, Explorer's Scope, Tusk Guard Captain, Thriving Grove, Teemer Battle Rage, Elvish Mystic. I mean, these borderless cards are always beautiful. They always look so nice. Windcaller Aven, Dwarven Hammer, Drown in Sorrow, Spectral Grasp, Firemind Vessel. So our rare or whatever it is going to be here. Let's see. Gorex the Tomb Shell, Zombie Turtle, and. Nice! Heroic Intervention, pretty good. And Stitcher Gerolf. All right, so not the best, although Heroic Intervention is a pretty good hit, I think. Overall, though, I would say this was a pretty fun mystery pack, and the Vorinclex really kind of took it home for us. Thanks again to my locals for doing that. If you guys want to see more videos like this, let me know in the comments down below. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.